I'm Scott with Hammer in Hand. In previous segments, we've described the science of Karuna. This segment, we're going to do the craft of Karuna. This is our one of the fun parts of the project on the interior. This is our staircase made with bird's eye maple. It's a laminated tread. The beauty of a little project like this is it requires great skill and a lot of layout. It begins with, we have a LVL stringer that's led into the wall. It's a 20-inch stringer that's led into this wall when we framed it. And second part is a steel fabrication of a plate and a tread that comes all the way across. Those get installed in the framing stage. Once we went to sheetrock, we got to begin the really fun work, which was building these nice wood boxes and installing our balusters. The way these things go together, we're going to describe over here. Okay, so as we mentioned, this is a buildup of wood and steel. You can see our substrate, which is this 3/8 steel that goes back, and it's welded onto a really big backing plate that's bolted onto our LVL. Then we take our slabs, first one goes in, and then we install our balusters. We have our layout that runs the whole way down. And then we've used a couple poplar furring strips to get it to the right thickness. The thickness of the tread is really key because we can't have more than 4 inches right here. Just like the balusters, you can't have a bigger than a 4-inch sphere that can penetrate through. It's the same on the riser. As I mentioned, this is a buildup of many different parts. So we have our 3/8 steel plate that runs the whole way across and then onto our backing plate. We have our maple tread, and then we have another piece that gets veneered onto the bottom. And then a couple filler pieces. These are a couple pieces of poplar. Now we did this whole thing with a hidden fastening system. So we drilled some holes into our steel plate and we have some 1/4-20 screws that go through here and then they screw right into this piece of maple right here. The piece that runs on the bottom just gets nailed on. So you don't see any fasteners, no plugs or anything. So it really looks tricky when you look at it because you can't really tell how the whole thing was put together. Wood, when you stack this many pieces together, it can move back and forth. So we built in a little bit of something to allow for that movement. And basically what it is, it's just a little piece of foam. It's only a 16-inch thick, and it goes right on the bottom. And our next piece of maple goes onto that. Now, if this banding wants to expand or contract with seasonal movement or a change in relative humidity, it's not going to blow the whole joint apart. This whole thing is glued together. So we want to allow for seasonal movement. Then the whole thing is finished with Osmo, which is a natural oil finish. We can take a look over on the other side and just see how the balusters penetrate through, and then that's the tour. So from this angle, you can kind of see the end grain of everything, and you can see how the balusters penetrate through. We had our steel plate pre-drilled, so layout was key. The layout between these balusters, between the treads, is the exact same as the layout in the field of the tread. So that required a bunch of story poles and some really accurate layout. The tubing is a 3/8 diameter stainless steel tubing. We had our fabricator weld a machine thread on one end, and then on the other end there's a wood thread, and we installed a wood beam that's up in the ceiling to support all these guys the whole way across. That was done in the framing stage. That's really about it. At the end of the day, it all meets code. It looks really pretty. It was a really fun project to put together.